Do you know that if you buy a resale property, there's a high chance that you are making profit for the seller? So how do you ensure that you don't overpay for that resale property? And as importantly, how can you still make sure that you have potential growth left for yourself? Hi, I'm Joel, Daddy Property Chef. In addition to being a property consultant who loves to cook with his family, I am a homeowner just like you. So, many potential homeowners tell me that they don't care about profits in the property that they buy. They tell me that it's because it's meant to be a roof over their head. However, I will always ask them this, okay, but can you bear to lose money then? Every single dollar is hard-earned, and to most owners, we value our homes as an asset. To me, capital pumped into a home must at the very least be preserved. To lose your money because of a bad property buying miscalculation will impact the future of you and your family. What if I tell you that there is a simple step to make sure you don't lose money? I've been sharing with you a simple framework in my previous videos that can put a stop to all these worries. Do you catch all those? Regardless, if you have not been thinking about planning for your next property purchase, now may be a good time to connect with me to protect your assets. Reach me on Facebook or message me to find out how easy it is to safeguard your family's future. I hope to see you soon. Until then, I'm Joel. Let's make you do well. Hello, good evening, everybody. Yes, how are you all today? Okay, wait, give me a second. Trying to get everything set up correctly. Okay, so it was a bit impromptu. I don't really think there'll be much people tonight, but if you are joining Joel, Daddy Property Chef tonight, thank you so much. Okay, so it's been a very exciting half a year. Okay, we are now in the sixth month of the year. So basically, what we are seeing now is we have a lot of, how should I put it? There is a lot of speculations in the market. We keep hearing that, oh, there's going to be cooling measures. We keep hearing that there's going to be developer going to drop price. We talk here, developer going to up the price. We hear that the market is going to crash. But then suddenly on the news, we see, the HDB market is going superbly. Okay, HDB market price going up. Resale market, I just washed my hair. I'm very lazy to go and style it, so that's why I decided not to style my hair today. Okay, but anyway, for those of you who are with me right now, okay, thank you for joining me. If you can, please help me like and share this, because tonight we're going to look at purely on the current property news. We're going to see how the market is really going to impact us now. Okay. But the interesting thing, let me do some simple sharing first. Okay, while we wait for more people to come in. Well, not much. Okay. But tonight, okay, for tonight, I'm going to have a co-host, okay? A very beautiful co-host. So as the topic for today says, how will property market go forward? So, who better to judge this than our future generation? Okay, so for tonight, I'm going to invite my daughter, Rianne. Hello, Rianne, come. Yes, hi. Say hi to everybody. Say hi.
Hi.
Hello, everybody. So if you have seen, I believe you have seen my second daughter, Rianne, with me cooking. My youngest daughter Roseanne has joined me in my home videos. Okay, so today, my eldest daughter. Why my eldest daughter on Diary of a Property Agent? Very simple, because
She, how are you? Can you share with us? How are you? You must sit closer. I'm worried that they cannot hear you. Come.
Okay.
For those of you who are seeing this, if you can hear, right? If you can hear, right? Maybe. Can you hear Rian? If you all can hear Rian, like give me a thumbs up so that I know that she her voice you all can hear. Wait, maybe you all say something to all the uncle, aunties, doctor, success on
hi,
on Facebook. Huh? Yes.
Please like and share this video.
Wow, very good. Okay, so Rian, why don't you share with our audience how old are you this year?
I'm 12 this year.
Okay, so you are 12. You're going for your PSLE this year, right?
Yeah.
Well, then unfortunately you're going for a COVID vaccine soon.
I think it's okay.
You think it's okay, serious?
Yeah.
Okay, so basically why we have you here tonight? Okay, first and foremost, because tonight I'm gonna talk about some of the things that is on property market. And unfortunately, Rian, all these things will affect our future generation. And that means who?
Me.
Yes, yourself. Okay. So come, let's see who is. Hey, Anjali. Hello. Hello. Say hello to Auntie Anjali.
Hi.
Must say louder. She cannot hear you.
Hi, Auntie Anjali.
Okay. Yes. Okay. So Auntie Anjali is here as well. Okay, the thing now is this. The thing now is, okay, basically, every single thing that happens now, you see, last time when daddy was young, right? When daddy was young, yeye and ama, right? They will not tell me about property. You know why?
Because they're not property agent.
No, nothing to do with that.
Yeah.
Just because I'm property agent, I know where.
Yeah,
no, I can tell you, I'm not a property agent. The market still don't know what is going on. No, I'm serious. Okay, so why akong ama, okay, they are also unable to teach us because the market keep changes every day. Every day keep changing. Okay, every day keep changing. So the thing is they themselves are also unaware.
Yeah,
and last
so
time people are not so educated. Last time people are not so educated, right? Not like you're today. I mean, guys, can you believe when I was looking at Rian's max question, it's what I learned in my secondary school. I don't know if the parents now experience this or not. I mean, if you have school going children, right, they are in their primary school, then PSLE this year. Okay, if you agree with what I'm saying, like that their max question is crazy. Okay, if you think that their max question is crazy, right, it's like I personally feel these are the questions I did in my secondary school, you know. And they are doing if you agree with what I'm saying, their best questions are crazy. What they're learning now is crazy, right? Okay, please smack the like button. Okay, smack the like button and even comment, it's crazy. Okay.
Yeah, that's exactly why we have apps like SnapPass.
What?
We have apps like SnapPass.
What's SnapPass?
Like you take picture of the math question that you send one.
Then
there's like tutors.
We take picture of the next question and then send to tutors.
Yeah.
Well, nowadays the young people are so fortunate. Not like our generation. Our generation.
No, we already tried one app, but it's not like us. Auntie tried one. Then we take picture and said the question is not complete.
Oh, the question like that.
But we took the whole picture of the question already.
No, it means the question is not complete. It means that the question, right, is not written correctly. It's not in the full form. That means some information is missing lah. Maybe something like that. That's why the question is not complete. Okay, wait. Go too far away. We come back to property. Okay, so as I was saying last time when I was young, right? Our parents, your grandparents, they don't really understand how the market works. So last time I tell you, very simple one. Can you have a concept of how much is money, right?
Yeah.
1 million is how many zero?
Six.
6 zero, right? So it's 1 million a lot?
Private.
To you, right? To you is a lot, right?
Yeah.
Do you know that a lot of private houses is more than $1 million? Do you know the house that my daddy bought last year, right? It's less than 100,000. Wow, less than 1 million. Do you see the house? We brought you to see the house, right?
At the Woodlands.
You saw the house, right?
That was so nice, that house.
Yeah, is it big?
Yeah.
It's less than 1 million, you know.
Yeah, because It's not like private property.
Also. Oh, it is private property. It's EC that becomes a private property.
What's EC?
EC executive condominium. Ah, okay, these are all very complicated. Next time I slowly teach you. But you think such a big house, right? You feel that the house is big, right?
Yeah.
Is it as big as ours, huh? The rental house now? Yeah. Almost, right? Okay, so I ask you one thing. If I were to tell you this house less than 1 million, you think cheap? What's your concept? You don't know, right? You wouldn't know, right? But if I were to tell you the new houses now built now, right? Half the size of that Woodlands house, or half the size of our house now, right?
More expensive, millions of dollars.
Yeah, you know,
Yeah, because based on the average of the houses, you know, now the newly furnished ones are all like very expensive.
What's scary, man? A 12-year-old girl telling us this thing. How you know this?
I see you walking around the house holding the phone calling the dog.
Okay, at least you do hear what I say, that's good enough, okay? So you see, ladies and gentlemen, while we are working from home, our children actually pick up what we are doing. So if you are really working at home, right, your children will know. If you are lazing around, your children will also know. Agree or not? Agree, for those who agree with this, what should they do? I also don't know. Never mind, I don't do anything. Okay,
share this video,
yeah. For those of you who agree with what I'm saying, right, please help me like and share, okay? But tonight, we are going to talk about some interesting topics. Okay, so Rian, come, let's have a look at some news. Okay, we're gonna cut into two parts. Okay, tonight I'm not gonna make it very long. But for those of you who have questions, okay, those of you who actually have questions, feel free to leave it in the comment section. Okay, I'll go through with you. Like example, if you want to check, how much is my property now? Okay, what is the estimated valuation? This and that. Okay, feel free to leave it in the comment section. I will get to you. Okay, I'll get to you.
Maybe you should have a Q&A the next session.
Maybe I have a Q&A at the end of the session. Okay, but today, yes, Rian. So we are going to look at today's property market from a 12 years old point of view. Okay. So I'm gonna share some news articles. Okay, this is what is going on now in the market. Okay, this is what is going on now in the market. Okay, let's look at this first. Okay, can you see this? Can you see this article? Wait, let me make it bigger. Okay, what's the header?
Global homes prices rise most since 2006, fueling bubble concerns. Singapore leads rise in Asia.
Okay, so tell me, what does this tell you?
I have no idea. The only thing I can pick up is that the prices of homes are getting more and more expensive.
Okay, so basically what this says is the home prices, right?
Yeah.
Is going up. The most is going up the most. That means the growth is the most since 2006. You're not even born yet, right? You're not even born yet.
3 years before.
Yeah. So imagine 15 years ago, we are rising the most against 15 years ago. So in Singapore, okay, do you know what is bubble? What is a bubble? You blow bubble, right?
Yeah.
You like to blow bubble with your sisters, right? No, now you're old already, you don't like. Okay, so but you know what will happen to bubble?
They pop,
right? Bubble pop. So what does this mean, bubble concerns? It actually means that people are worried. People are worried that this price keep going, keep going as high as possible. Then suddenly you burst. Then one day just everything come tumble down.
Oh.
Scary, right? This type of bubble. But it's good for you, right? Because you're buying house next time, right?
But the sellers it's bad for them.
Yeah, it'll be the homeowners, right, who buy for profit, they'll be stuck. But good for you next time, right? Correct?
Yeah.
But now still far away, you're only 12, still far away. Okay, let's see what happens along the way. But so it says that Singapore leads rise in Asia. So what does that mean? That means our property prices are going the fastest.
In Asia?
Yeah. In the whole of Asia, our property price, Singapore's property price is going the fastest.
There are quite a lot of countries in Asia.
Yeah, correct. There are quite a lot of, I think you must speak louder. There are quite a lot of countries in Asia.
That's scary. And Singapore is so small only.
Yeah, correct.
We have the least space to build houses.
Yeah. Well, even you know, you have the least space to build houses. Okay, so
you're the smallest country and best space.
Yeah, correct. So basically, right, in Asia, we are the one with the biggest price gain. Okay, well, price went up the highest, followed by South Korea, then Japan. Okay, the world's priciest property market is Hong Kong. Isn't that amazing?
Really? I didn't know it's Hong Kong.
Right? I was shocked. I was like, Hong Kong? Okay, but anyway. Well, this is the first news. Okay, now next, I want to show you this news. Okay, I'll show you this news. Tell me for me.
Singapore's richest property family wants of cooling measures.
Okay, so what is this Singapore's richest property family? That means they own a lot of property.
Yeah.
Okay, who are they? Can you read for me? This part. Okay, starting from here.
City Developments LTD Chairman
Quek Ling Bing
noted that the residential market has been performing well, though he cautioned that if property prices continue to rise, there may be a time that further cooling measures could be introduced to control the prices.
Okay, wait, records from the company's annual shareholder meeting show, which is held 2 months ago, on the about maybe slightly more than 1 month ago, April 30th. Okay, so I ask you one thing. So Mr. Quek, he's the chairman, that means the big boss of this company called City Developments Limited. They are actually developers. That means they build houses. Okay, they buy land, then they build houses. So,
and then they sell the house, right?
Yes, then they sell the house. Then I ask you one thing. It's stated that he noted that the residential market has been performing well, though he cautioned that if property market continue to rise, there may be a time that further cooling measures could be introduced to control the prices. Correct? So, Rian, I ask you one thing. When he says this, is he worried? Do you feel that he's worried when he says this?
I think he is.
Yeah, you think he is, right? I mean, this is from Bloomberg. Bloomberg is not Singapore's news. It's actually for a global news. Okay, so it's for investments. Investment means what? Put money, earn money.
Okay, yeah.
Okay, so it seems that from this article, Mr. Quek himself is worried, right? Worried about this cooling measures, right? You know what's cooling measure? Okay, cooling measures are things that government does, Okay, when the market is too hot, what does it mean, man? That means people keep buying, right? So they are worried about the bubble bursting.
Is it cooling measures to prevent people from buying so much?
From overbuying. From overbuying. That means it's not just overbuying. It's like, I don't have so much money, but I still want to buy. I keep rushing into the market. Why? Because Rian is buying, so I also want to buy. Then we are buying, so other people also want to buy. So there's this term called speculating. That means they don't know what they are doing. They just blindly go in. You know FOMO, right? That's FOMO, right? Hey, you know what's FOMO, That's a millennium term, Fear of missing out. FOMO. You never heard before, Oh my goodness, you're a good girl. Okay. The interesting thing now is we see from this article, right?
Yeah.
Mr. Quek is worried,
Yeah.
Okay, let's have a look at when this article came out. May 25th, so it's last week, or the week before, okay?
Why so late?
Recently only, okay? 25th, now I'm going to show you another article. Okay, it's from Forbes. Can you read for me?
Singapore property tycoons bet big on housing as demand hits up.
Yeah, demand hits up.
So there's a lot of people wanting to buy.
Mr. Quek, you don't know how he looks like. This is Mr. Quek, Quek Lim Bing. Okay? The chairman of City Developments.
Okay. Whoa, he's a billionaire.
Yes, he's a billionaire. Whoa. Okay, so can you read for me just the first paragraph?
Billionaires Quek Ling Bing and Wee Cho
Yao.
Yao, among the richest real estate tycoons in Singapore, are placing big bets in state land auctions as the developers seek to replenish their land banks amid rising housing demand in the city state.
Okay. Rian, I just ask you one thing. So, of course, Mr. Quek and Mr. Wee, you know, Mr. Wee owns a bank.
Owns a bank?
The UOB bank belongs to him.
Oh
like,
what?
Right.
What?
Okay. Mr. Quek also owns a bank. But Singapore don't have. It's called Hong Leong Bank. Hong Leong Bank in Malaysia.
No wonder he's so rich. He owns a bank and he owns a company that sells houses. Why?
Okay, so I ask you one thing. So you see, these two men are the richest real estate tycoons in Singapore, right?
Okay, yeah.
So what are they doing? You from the first paragraph, what are they doing?
They are placing big bets. So that means they are trying their best to like get more land.
Correct.
They're paying a lot
smart.
Of money.
Okay. So Mr. Quek and Mr. Wee are buying more lands. Trying to buy more lands, Okay.
Then the last article, a lot of people are rushing to buy now.
But last article, what did Mr. Quek say? What did Mr. Quek say?
He still. Oh my goodness.
He say maybe cooling measure, right?
Yeah, but you still go and buy, and then later there are people like still buying. They are like control prices. The price will go. But,
so weird, right?
But he's paying a lot to buy the houses. Yeah, so you'll be losing money instead of if you buy.
So why would he do that, right? So but we are right.
Yeah.
On one end, Mr. Quek,
he's worried, and then the other one he's rushing to auctions
to buy
land.
So his actions and his words. His action and his words. We are right.
Why is he doing that?
You're confused, right? You're confused about what the adults are doing, right?
Yeah.
Oh, you're confused, right?
Mm-hmm.
Don't talk about you, right? I'm also confused, you know. So I mean, Daddy is a property agent, I'm also confused, On one hand, one of the biggest developers in Singapore tells us, cooling measure coming, blah 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 blah. So cooling measure coming, so property price should be coming down,
Yeah.
Correct. Then on the other hand, he keep rushing to buy land. Then I show you one thing, Please, I'm going to show you one thing. Okay, so there's a piece of land in Ang Mo Kio. Ang Mo Kio, you know that they sell a lot of houses in Ang Mo Kio, right?
Yes.
Okay, so.
You're the featured agent there.
Okay. But you know everything.
Very proud.
Okay. So, Mr. Wee is UOL. Mr. Quek is City Development, CDL. So, can see, there's this land in Ang Mo Kio, right? Then, Mr. Wee won the bid. Highest bid. And the second is who? Mr. Quek. Correct?
Oh my gosh. 381 million?
Yeah. 381 what? Million. Or 381 million. Sing dollars. Okay? Never mind.
It went up by 100 million.
Yeah. Sorry?
It went up by 100 million.
Oh, no. It's not. This is not. 381 million is Sing dollars. You see with the S, right? It's Sing dollars.
Yeah.
Usually on this type of news, right? You see, Forbes is a US news. So without the S, right? This is in USD, US US dollars. So 288 million, right? Is US dollars. This is Sing dollars. Okay.
Oh.
So the interesting thing,
the currency is much stronger in US.
Yeah, you can say that. You can say that. Okay, but now I want you to see this thing. You see, this is Tengah Garden Walk. You know what's Tengah, right?
No.
Then you know the big piece of land? Last time the forest, now being cleared to build houses, that one.
No.
Yes. Correct. That big piece of land that was that is now used to build houses. Okay.
It's global warming.
Global.
The polar bears are all dying.
Okay. We don't go so far first. Okay. So this is the interesting thing. Okay. You see who won the bid. Okay. Do strong interest among the housing. Blah, 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 blah. Okay. And equally own joint venture of who are? Who is this?
City Developers is Mr. Quek. What?
Mr. Quek. So Mr. Quek owns the Mr. Quek won the bid.
Is that Taurus Properties?
Yeah, they this developer is called Taurus Property. This developer is called Taurus Property. Okay, so Taurus Property is a joint venture by CDL and another company. Okay, called MCL. All the L, we have to all put all the L behind. Okay, so basically, right? You tell me. Who won? CDL won. So CDL won this piece of land.
Oh my gosh, 400 million, that's even more.
No, just 400 million. Yeah, 400 million is more than this, huh?
Yeah.
300, huh? Why? Because this piece of land is bigger, This piece of land is bigger. But this is, this land can build 620 houses.
620?
Yes. And has 12 blocks. A lot, right? Scary, yeah? Okay, so basically, what do you think, Rian? You tell me what I think. So, you see Mr. Quek, one thing, one way, on one end, he tells you he's worried. On his shared meeting, annual meeting. On the other end, he's buying land. What do you think? From a 12 years old point of view, what do you think?
Let's trust the process, see what happens.
Trust the process?
Yes.
So, you mean to say that based on what he's doing, you think the cooling measure will come?
Maybe it won't.
But based on what he's doing, do you think he's still optimistic about the property market?
Yeah.
I think so, right? I think
he's pretty optimistic and pay so much.
Yeah,
I mean he is a billionaire, so yeah.
I mean, honestly speaking, when you see our news, right? One hand he's worried, He says that he's worried. On the other hand, he's still buying land at this type of price. So you yourself feel that he still thinks that the market is going up, right?
Yeah, of course.
You see, even a 12-year-old girl understands this logic. So this is the issue now. This is the issue now with the market. I personally feel this, honestly speaking, that the developers, they themselves are so bullish about the market, The developers, they themselves are so bullish about the market. And based on the global news, it's not even Singapore news already, it's global news. Everybody thinks that Singapore is going to make it. Everybody thinks that despite the pandemic, you do know now we're in COVID, right?
Yeah.
So, in your personal opinion, with the global situation like this, should the property market be going up or down? What do you think? Should the price be going up or down?
Down.
Why down? Why do you think it should go up?
Because people now losing their jobs.
Ladies and gentlemen, you see, even a 12 years old understand this thing. People are losing their job. Okay? A lot of people are losing their job, right?
Yeah.
So they cannot afford to pay for the house, right?
Yeah.
But what do we see? Based on the three articles that we saw just now, right?
It's going up.
Do you think it makes sense?
No. I mean, there are more people buying because they're like richer people. They have a lot of money to spend to go and buy all these properties on these landed places. But there's like people out there like having to sell their houses because they already lost their job.
You see, I mean, ever since last year, when I've been actively doing Facebook Live, trying to share all this with everybody, right? I mean, I'm not trying to say, oh no, we are doomed, I'm not trying to say that. Because ultimately, if nobody buys, the market is going to be even worse. I'm not someone who wants the market to die as well. Please understand, I'm a property agent. It's not in my interest that the market dies. But the thing is, my concern, not just as a property agent, but as a father, okay, is the fact that, you see, even a 12-year-old girl understands this logic that the market should not be performing well, but yet everybody is rushing into it. If the developers are so bullish about the market, why? Honestly speaking, there's this saying in Chinese, I don't know if you all heard about it. It's called 没有买卖就没有伤害. Okay, if there is no buying and selling, right, there won't be any harm done. So the thing is, when the developers are selling, right, of course, there are still people buying. I mean, we can see from, especially last year. In fact, if everybody takes note of the property market, Rian, I share one thing with you. You know, when, you know, HDB houses, right?
Yeah.
We're staying in HDB house, right?
Yeah.
So this, the HDB house belongs to the government. So they build this house, they try to sell it at lower cost to us. They don't sell cheaper to us.
Yeah,
okay, so everybody has a house, have a roof over our head. Okay, so what happened is they sell to us at this thing called subsidized price. Do you know what subsidized?
Subsidized means lesser.
Okay, lesser. That means they fork out a bit or they sell it to you at a cheaper price. And everybody trying to sell at a higher price. If you are the one, will you sell at a higher price? You buy cheap already. Next time when you sell, will not sell higher or sell lower. You see, everybody is the same. Don't need to compare. Everybody is the same. Even for kids, it's also the same. So let me ask you one thing. Do you think it's fair for the government? They sell to us cheap, then we keep selling at a higher price.
Yeah, then we just keep selling.
Yeah, so basically, right, what happened from this was the government came in with a lot of cooling measures. Okay, government came in with a lot of cooling measures. So because of this, the pricing start to come down.
Yeah, because lesser people start buying because of the cooling measures.
Correct. But did you know, suddenly the price shoot up all the way. I show you this. Okay. You see, this
article. What's clawbacks?
Imposing clawbacks. Okay.
I only know drawbacks.
Drawbacks, that means they want to take back something.
In way, HDB lottery effect, Singapore miles raising subsidies. Imposing clawbacks.
Okay, wait. Let me show you what is called lottery effect. Let me see if it actually.
A lot of people can buy, but then they lose money also.
No, they bought this HDB flat at subsidized prices, right? Then when they sell, right, they get a good profit. So it's like striking lottery. People every time say that this is like striking lottery. So this is the lottery effect. Can you read this part for perspective?
For perspective, in April alone, $21 million HDB flats changed hands in the resale market. A total of 82 HDB flats were sold for at least 1 million last year, compared with 64 in 2019. Most of these million-dollar flats are located in areas such as Central Singapore, Bishan, and Queenstown.
So what does this tell you?
There's a lot of people buying.
21 what?
21 million.
Dollar flats. So how much does the HDB flat cost? $1 million. Is that scary?
Yeah.
our condo is not even $1 million. HDB flat is $1 million.
The government is selling it out at like 21 million and you're making...
No, it's not. No, it's not. Government selling it at 21 million.
Well, 1 million.
No, it's not. It means the government sold the house to them. We don't know how much the houses were cost last time. But now these owners are selling the houses at $1 million.
Oh my gosh.
More so expensive than our condo.
Yeah.
Isn't that scary?
And your HDB
flat. Location is good lah. It's nearer to town lah. It's nearer to town lah. But it's HDB flats lah.
Yeah.
It's HDB flats. Aren't you worried? Next time can you buy a house?
I'm pretty sure condos are like... Some condos are lesser than 1 million.
Yeah, you're right. A lot of condos are lesser than $1 million.
This is not even landed property.
Yes.
This is a HDB flat.
Yes, HDB.
Then most people live in and you're selling it for $1 million. Is it even furnished?
Oh, you know a lot.
Exactly.
You're very funny. Are you? So, I think it's quite scary. Right? So, can you imagine next time when you grow up, when you start your own family, or when even if you're single, you want to buy a house, you think it's going to cost you more than $1 million?
Yeah, definitely.
I think so, right? I think even places like Choa Chu Kang is going to be 1 million already.
Yeah, it's like shooting up, the prices are shooting up. And I'm only 12. Like when I'm older, like I'm 20 plus, it's going to be like a few million dollars for my HDB flat. That would be scary.
Yeah, I think that is scary. I honestly think that is scary. That's why I share this thing with a lot of people. That is the fact. Because why? One thing, of course, another thing is when they buy high, they need to sell even higher, right? So you ask him, if you today buy $1 million, how much you need to sell? Above 1 million?
Yeah.
But do you think they can sell above 1 million? I don't know. But if they can sell above 1 million, I think it would be very scary, right? Correct?
You need to have a good property agent. Yes, please, good property agent. Got one over there also. Aspiring one.
Aspiring one, Roseanne. Okay, I show you one thing. Okay. This is actually what we call the resale statistics. Okay. So it gives us an idea of how much the prices are. Okay, come, let's see for registered resale application. Okay, median price. Okay, no. This one too. We look at the price index. Okay.
What's the price index?
Price index means the changes. Okay. So you see,
Yes, I see percentage.
Percentage. Okay, wait.
I got 0.0%.
That means no growth, lah. When it's negative, it means that there's
a drop in price.
Okay. So you go at reading graph already, right?
Oh my goodness.
Goodness what?
There is one very high spike there.
Yeah, so you see, from 1994, that time daddy and mommy haven't
met. There was one yet. Spike there also.
We met when? I think it's year 2000 or 2001. I think it's 2001. Was it?
2001.
Yeah, we met in year 2000, right? I think it's 2000, sorry, 2000. So my daddy and mommy met around here. Okay, third quarter. Okay, so it's still reasonable, right? Reasonable,
Yeah.
Then it drop. Then around
it's a very
here,
small drop only.
Yeah, around here. Hey, we bought. I think we bought our house around here.
Okay.
In 04, we bought our first HDB flat. So it was a bit on the rise, Then it dropped again. Then it slowly went up. You tell me when was the highest? Can I see from this graph? You tell me when was the highest.
2012,
2013
there.
Yeah, around 2012, 2013. So 2012, 2013, how old were you? 3 years old. Four years old. Around 4 years old. When you were 4 years old, that time was when the HDB prices was the highest. Then it dropped. You see how it dropped?
I only saw a bit.
Dropped a bit. Actually quite a lot. quite a lot.
Based on the increase, it's quite a lot.
Yeah, based on the increase, it's quite a lot. Okay? Drop, till here. Then suddenly,
it's going back up again.
In 2 years, you see, when did it go up? When did it go up?
2013, 2012.
2020, 2012. Hey, you tell me, 2020, what happened?
COVID.
Weird, right?
Yeah.
So when COVID happened, so now it's against all us already, correct? Instead of something happened, price go down. Something happened, price go up. So all the homeowners, you pray for something worse to happen, right?
Yeah.
No, please don't happen anymore. Daddy already very chuan. Cannot. I want to go for viewing also very difficult already. Please don't. So you also agree that don't make sense, right?
Yeah. It's the price is going up during this pandemic.
Yeah,
and the
correct.
Price should be dropping because there are lesser people buying.
Precisely, instead of the price dropping, right, the price is just going all the way up.
People buying like it's Shopee.
Shopee.
Like it's Shopee.
Okay. So I think even for you feel that it's don't understand, right? You also cannot understand, right?
People very bored at home. After they finish their work, they just go and buy.
After they what?
After they finish their work, they just go and buy.
They finish their work, they just go and buy. Okay. Okay, so you see, so many new lands that come out. You see, especially when you see on news, you know Straits Times is our news, right?
Yes.
Land star developer made record setting bid on Tuesday. So you see, on one end we have HDB prices going up.
Mm-hmm.
On the other end, we have developers, land staff. What does land staff mean?
They are very greedy for land.
Very hungry for land. Don't say greedy. We don't say developer is greedy because they still need to sell their property.
Sorry. No offense.
Okay, we don't say developer greedy.
Sorry, my vocab bank is very small. No offense.
Very fake. Okay. You see, everything says record breaking lah, land stuff lah. So as a young person, we don't say you're a kid. As a young person, what does this tell you? What do you feel when you see words like this?
Yeah, buying at very, very high prices.
So when you see this, right, do you think the market is good or bad?
I guess it's good.
But weird, right?
Yeah.
I think you're frowning already because you don't understand, right?
Yeah.
How come there's a pandemic and then developer is thinking that the market is good?
Yeah, they're just all... It's a bit like panic buying.
Panic buying?
Yeah.
Sorry, come here.
Panic buying.
Oh my
goodness. It's a bit like panic buying, like all the toilet paper and the Maggie.
All the toilet paper and the Maggie. Okay, so we have a look at this. We're gonna have a look at this. Do we see this Tengah site fetch a top bid of 400 million or $603 per square foot? You know what's the meaning of per square foot? You know what's the meaning of per square foot?
Like 1 feet, then 1 feet, so 1 feet, then 4 feet.
Yes, so every feet, we give a price to every feet. Okay? $603 per feet.
Per feet.
Yes. So I'm gonna log in. We're gonna see the how come I cannot log in?
Why?
I don't know why I cannot log in. What happened? Wait. Let me
watch this, log into what?
I'm gonna log into some data. Today is not just about Facebook Live.
Can you cover your password or something? Oh wait, never mind. It's covered.
don't worry. Cannot see. Even if they can see, I can change my password. Okay, come. Let me show something. Land sales.
Yeah.
Wait. What happened? Wait. We look at land sales. Okay. Oi, what happened?
What are you doing?
Okay. Don't laugh at me lah. Oh, my phone's so visible already. Ah, tenang kawan, close. Okay. So you see ah, just now with that land, piece of land, right? We say the highest bid was 603 per square foot. So the cost of the cost, right? The break even, that means if the developer, they buy the land already, they need to build, right?
Yeah.
They need to flatten the land, they need to build up the house, right?
Yeah.
They say that it's going to cost $1,059, okay, about $1,050, okay, we say $1,050, okay. They say it's going to cost about maybe $1,050 per square foot. So if today, you are running a store, so your cost price, you know, right, you are good in max already, right? Correct. So you know that the cost for this item is $1,050.
Mm-hmm.
How much should you sell it for to make a profit? If you want a 10%
profit.
10% profit. Oh no, okay. For $1,050, right? How much is a 10% profit?
$150.
1,050. Not 1,500. 1,050. 10% is 1,500. Mm-hmm, yeah. 1,050. Yeah. But you think 10% enough or not? You spend so much effort, 10% enough or not? So at least need a 20, right? Or 15, yeah. 15. You say 15. So it's about $150, right?
Yeah.
So if you know $150, this piece of land per square foot need to cost how much? 1050 plus 150, 1,002, right? 1,002. You know 1,002, based on 1,002, how much our house is going to cost? I show you.
Look at all the tiles on the floor.
Look at all the tiles on the floor, yeah. Look at
about 1 foot each the side. We have so many tiles.
Okay.
And it's 1,000 each.
Come, let's do a simple calculation. Let's do a simple calculation. So, you know, right, our house, the one in Woodlands, right,
mm-hmm.
is 1,220, 1,292 square feet.
Oh my goodness.
So, if is our house at 1,002 per square foot, times 1,002,
$1 million plus.
$1 million plus. It's $1 million plus a lot, you know. $1.5 million, you know.
Yeah.
You know how much I bought? 780,000. Almost half. It's almost half. That's the house I bought, lah. But of course nowadays, the house is not so big. Okay, house is not so big. Maybe we have around 900 square feet, lah. 900 square feet for three bedder. So there's three bedrooms.
Yeah.
Okay, we'll talk about EC. Oh yeah, by the way, I need to share this thing with you. Just now we're talking about EC, right? So EC means that this land belongs to HDB. So it's a subsidized house.
The HDB?
No, it's not under HDB. It's a subsidized house. So by right, this house is cheaper than most private outside. At this price. Your jaw like gonna drop already. This is subsidized house, you know. The price, makes sense, Okay, never mind, I show you. So, if we say a new three-bedder in the market, right? The new EC, this new EC three-bedder is going to at 1,002 per square foot, okay? This is the price of a three-bedder, you know. It's going to be smaller than our condo. Much smaller.
Yeah.
Still come with balcony. Our house doesn't have balcony, right?
Yeah.
So, the almost 1,003 square feet is the whole house. So this 900 square feet still got balcony one. The balcony need to count money one, you know.
Yeah, because still got.
So this is going to be the price of a three bedder. You think makes sense?
It definitely does. Our house is so much bigger. Still got a swimming pool downstairs.
This one going to have swimming pool.
Really?
But you think this price you will buy or not? But that's the problem. Next time you this price, you also cannot buy. When you grow up, it's not going to be this price already, what?
It's going to be much more expensive.
Yeah, maybe 2,000 per square foot, you know?
Oh my goodness.
Don't scare. Slowly. Oh,
now it's like...
Don't worry.
It's so expensive already.
Yeah, that's why I want to... That's why tonight is not just about sharing on Facebook Live. It's also about sharing some knowledge with you. I need to also understand houses. You know what I'm worried about? I'm worried that in the future, where you all slowly grow up, you see your friends stay condo, you also want to stay in condo. But can we afford to? You see, this is the thing.
Yeah.
This is the thing. So I don't want you to grow up having that aspect that, okay, my friends all have, I also want to have. This is the thing. Because we need to buy something that we can afford also. Okay,
because
so
I think most people can afford condos, just that it will affect their daily life, you know.
Yeah, la, of course lah. When you buy this type of price, of course it will affect. Okay, come, let's have a look at some other articles.
Maybe I have to eat Maggie Mee every day, but I won't mind. I need a Maggie Mee.
Every day eat Maggie Mee. Okay. Let's see this. Okay. Then just now, you know we buy resale condo, right? It's a second-hand one. Second-hand we call resale. That is people stay...
So sell again.
They sell, sell again. Resale. So you
that's
see...
A smart name.
What's a... What?
That's a smart name.
Okay.
Because some things, they have names that don't make sense.
So this is from Business Times. It's also our Singapore newspaper. You see what it says? Singapore condo resale volumes hit 11-year high.
Oh my goodness, 1.5%. Just now they were all zero point something.
Up 1.5% in April. That means from March to April, it went up 1.5% already.
What? and then you see the past few years is 0.something, right?
No, that's HDB.
It's still so expensive by 1 month. It's an 11-year high. Break the world record already.
So he says that HDB upgraders were likely drivers of condominium resale transactions in April. So let's have a look. Okay, 6.9% of resale volumes to units in outside of central region. OCR means outside. We are Choa Chu Kang, the outside of Singapore, like Akong Ama stay Sengkang, right? Sengkang is also OCR. Woodlands, where I bought the condo, also OCR. Orchard Road, all these are CCR, central. Okay, makes sense, or you think makes sense?
56.9%, it's more than half.
Wow, scary, right?
Oh,
wow, median gain, the gain is so high up. It's good, right? So I buy the condo good. Buy last year good.
Now it's so much more expensive.
Yeah, scary. But anyway.
But there's still so many people buying right now.
Yeah, there's a lot of people buying. They just
it's getting
buying.
More expensive and there's more people buying.
And what are we in?
A pandemic.
Cannot understand, but this is the reason why I always say you know, from the beginning of the year, actually from last year, people keep talking about cooling measures. You know, just now we were mentioning my cooling measures, you know, right?
Yeah, everybody is afraid of cooling measures, but they're all still buying.
They all just keep buying, but why? Why do you think this happened?
Because a lot of people are selling at very high price.
But it's like a cycle, right? Because more people buy, people sell higher, ma. Right?
So it keeps on going higher and higher and higher.
Yeah, so it just push everything.
So you buy at higher, so you need to sell at higher to like sort of beat other people's prices.
Yeah, don't you think it's
very competitive in the market.
Yeah, don't you think it's scary? Huh? What do you think?
it's gonna keep going higher and higher and higher. And what is in a pandemic? A pandemic. And it's so much higher.
Then I'm gonna show you this other news. I'm gonna show you one more news. Okay. Okay, tonight is not gonna be a long night because you are doing it together with me. I don't want to take too long. Okay. What does it say?
Private flat sales to foreign buyers 4 to 17 year low.
So just based on the title itself, what does it tell you?
So that means there are lesser foreign buyers buying private flats. Yeah.
As compared to 17 years ago, right?
Yeah. But then HDB and all those. So there are more Singaporeans buying, but there are lesser.
No, foreigners cannot buy HDB. They can only buy private properties in Singapore. Oh. So imagine just now we say that.
Because Singaporeans get like.
Just now we were saying that the prices 11 years high, right?
Yeah, now it's 7 years old.
But yeah, that means lesser foreigners buying in Singapore. But our price is 11 years higher. Isn't that wonderful? All Singapore buyers. Correct?
Yeah.
All Singapore buyers. Because foreigners are all time low. Do you think it's good?
Depends.
Stressful, right? For 12 years old, you must be, yeah. What is this? You understand? You
lesser foreigners are buying.
Probably
because they're very like rethinking about buying it because they cannot really come and like see the property, I guess. They may be scammed.
Yeah, I think so too, but I think the it's pretty scary, it's pretty scary that there are so many people, there are so many people still buying. If the foreigners are not buying, but it's so it means to say that the purchases are mostly from Singapore.
Yeah.
Oh, so scary. Eh? You think it's a good thing or bad?
I see the situation got cooling measures.
Well, politically correct answer you. you better than most of the analysts in the market already. I think you give a better answer than most of the property agents.
You
in the
must
market.
Have a neutral stance.
Oh, you must have a neutral stance.
No comments.
No comments is comments itself. Okay, come. Okay, so last but not least, let's have a look at this. Okay, I chanced upon this article. It says 6 bad property advice to avoid in Singapore. Okay, this is from Asia One. So it's some
bad
of
property
the,
advice.
Yeah, okay. Bad property advice.
Let's see.
Okay, let's see. Okay, the first one I think you already don't understand. The progressive payment scheme or deferred payment scheme will make properties more affordable.
Is it the government like subsidizing?
No, nothing to do with that. So basically, you want this? Okay, so it means to say that when you buy a house, right, most people, of course, you don't have the full cash to buy the house, correct?
Oh, I know. It's like banks like loan money.
Correct. Banks will loan you money to buy. So there's this two type of payment scheme.
So
I don't
you
go
pay
into details,
first,
too complicated.
The bank
will
pay
for you.
The
then you pay back.
But there's interest.
Correct. You are right. So they... By doing this, you make the property more affordable.
But you don't have the cash in hand, so you have to loan. You have no choice but to loan.
Oh, you see? Smart girl, I don't understand. But do you think it actually makes the house more affordable? You know it's affordable, right?
Yeah, it makes the house, I guess, in a way more affordable since you have...
But you have to pay more interest, right?
Yeah, but you can like pay bit by bit.
Yeah,
because you don't have the money in hand right now.
Yeah, that's... I personally think that it's good. It's good. It helps us to start off our journey, okay? Because you don't have the full amount. Then you do have a rich father, right? You know, right? You know our father got no money, right?
I think we are above average, slightly above.
You don't say this type of thing online, you know?
Why? What's wrong?
Oh, no, we are very average family. We are not above average. We are very average family. Okay, we are living in a rental average house, you know? I was thinking a rental house,
it's
you
because
know?
Of feng shui.
No!
Yeah!
You say something. Okay.
It's because whatever. We need the direction of the house. We need to be a square house because we have a lot of people in the family and we need good feng shui. If okay. It's okay, we can just buy one house that is near to the school.
Wow. See? So good. My daughter exposed all my secrets online. Okay, never mind. So the thing is, you see, of course, a lot of people don't have that money to directly buy a house, right?
Yeah.
So they need to borrow, ma. So they can borrow from banks, right?
Yeah.
But the scary part is when you borrow too much,
you cannot pay back.
You cannot pay back. It's scary, right? So
the
for
interest
this,
will keep going up.
Correct. So for this, right? I mean, I honestly feel okay, for those of you who are still with me, I'm not much viewers tonight. I totally understand because there's a lot of consumer seminar everywhere. But if anybody gets to see this later part, right, I hope y'all can keep this in mind. Y'all can keep this in mind. The fact that please understand when you over leverage, that means when you borrow too much money and you cannot pay, there's gonna be a problem, correct? There's going to be a problem. Like what Rianne says, the interest just keeps going up.
And you can't pay. Maybe by the time you actually get enough money, the amount that you need to pay will be 2 times the amount that you borrow.
Yeah, you see? Even
and
the young adults understand
this. And this is how people go
this.
Into bankruptcy.
Wow. Okay. So, when it comes to buying a house, my advice is, yes, we should leverage. Okay, we should leverage. We should take advantage of the loan structure, especially when now the loan is all-time low, even lower than when I bought last year. But the issue is, if you're not buying a need, you're not buying a house to stay, you're buying a house to invest, you better plan your sums carefully. Because if the returns is not enough, are you able to pay for the house?
Yes.
Okay, number one. Come, let's look at number two.
So if you need a good plan, you need to plan properly.
Correct.
You need a property agent to help you plan.
Well, tonight,
I'm promoting my father.
Tonight got a lot of 广告. Hey, no money to pay you endorsement fee, you know.
It's okay.
Okay.
You pay for my life.
I pay for your life. Oh, you're so good girl. Okay. Okay, property advice number two. Landlords should buy units near amenities to improve rental yield. Okay, what is the amenities like? Maybe any MRT, shopping mall, blah, 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 all these. So what they say is bad advice. Come, let's have a look. Should buy near rentability and rental yield.
Why?
Buying a unit close to a key could lower your rental US different at a premium. The rental yield is a measure.
It's bad advice. I think it's okay advice, but
yeah, I also I don't know. Like,
is it not good advice? Because people want to live near MRTs, because people like me are lazy and you need to go take MRT and bus.
Actually, they say this thing. Okay, there's these two things. Okay, one is rental yield. Rental yield means the money that you take back from the property. Because you rent out the property,
we're
doing
so
now.
So you earn it for the people.
That means the rental yield is good, means you get more money.
Yeah.
Rentability means the house is easy to rent out to people. Rentability means the house is easy to rent out to people. You see, they compare this house called Orchard Residences. Orchard Residences has high rentability. You sure or no? I don't understand it. Orchard Residences, the house is so expensive, so high rentability. Are you sure? I don't know. This is not an example. I think high rentability will be those that is near to malls or maybe MRT, right?
They got long.
Yeah, but Orchard Road.
Yeah, because Like,
this type of place, how to be high rentability? I don't understand. Eh. You see, just now we were saying that all the foreigners leave Singapore already, right?
It should be the foreigners that leave.
Yeah,
that they go and buy.
This type of place is foreigners, mostly foreigners who rent, right?
Town, like, go and see all the local attractions.
Yeah. No. Those, they will stay in hotel. I'm talking about people who stay long term in Singapore. Don't make sense, right?
Yeah.
I think, I don't know, but based on what I feel, rentability, like, you know, like, we stay Choa Chu Kang MRT, right? The two condo beside.
Yeah.
Do you think that the rentability for those condo will be good?
Will be
good, right? Then I think we compare something like this. Why Orchard Residences? I don't know. This one sounds weird. But I think we can both agree, right? Mm-hmm. When the condo is easier to rent out, when the condo is easy to rent out, the renter, the money come in will be also better, right?
Yeah.
And better rentability actually means that there is better demand, you know. I think better rentability means better demand. And when there's better demand, right, the price should go up, right?
Yeah, it'll go up.
So this part I don't understand. I don't understand. Okay, but then let's just have a look at okay, maybe I quote you guys an example. Because in Woodlands, right? In Woodlands now, the properties are in demand now. Okay, rental houses are in demand now. That's why even for our condo are not homes, right? We rented it out at the beginning of the year 2009. Now the current rental for that condo itself has already broke higher than 3,002, if I'm not wrong. Okay. But recently I'm gonna come into another unit. I think easily we can still get around maybe 2,800 to 3,000. I think these are not issues, you see. So I still think that rentability is a plus point, right? We talk about demand and supply, maybe not so much about amenities, but demand and supply. Correct? Huh? Okay, come, let's have a look at the other four points. Four points, man. Wrong sharing.
To the two viewers here, we really appreciate your presence.
Well, you're very politically correct one, eh? You are very scared of you, know?
We have been talking for 1 hour.
Yeah, almost 1 hour. Okay, come. Hey, next time round, you still want to come with me?
Okay.
Oh, next time round, we do again. Quite interesting. Living with your parents, buy a shoebox and rent it out as soon as you can afford it as an investment. You know, as a shoebox. You remember Susu's condo? Remember our tannery? The one room. Only one room. Those are not shoebox, those are big units already. So shoebox is only very small, half a size. So they are saying that if you are staying with daddy, mommy, right, you should buy a shoebox then rent out.
But they say this is the bad advice.
So do you know why it's a bad advice?
Why?
I tell you why. Susu, myself, and a lot of people who bought one bathers or those shoe box. For info, my one was not a shoe box, okay? It's 614 square feet. High ceiling with loft some more. 614 square feet. Slightly smaller than a three room flat. Yes. Penary. It's slightly smaller than a 3-room flat. I also lose money. Okay. But anyway.
Very long to start.
Yeah. So this is the thing. Rental-wise, maybe not so much of a problem. But when it comes to selling, you all will realize that the price always cannot keep. Okay, you always get low prices. This is the problem. Okay, this is the problem. So basically, I will advise you all to better speak to someone first. Okay, now I quote Rian's word. Speak to a property agent. Do a proper planning before you buy anything. If cannot afford to buy something bigger, right? My advice, then don't buy it all. Correct.
Exactly. If you cannot afford, then don't buy.
Yeah, then why go and buy something where you sure make money one? I'm so sorry, I'm a property agent, but I'm going to tell you. Right? Are you sure that it's going to confirm make money? But the profit is not confirmed, you know.
You should buy the one with higher probability.
Yes. coming out from a 12 years old PSLE going girl. Okay, come. Let's look at number 4. Put down a check to book the unit first. You can extend option to purchase if you can't get a loan on time. Okay. I this one I explain because I think you don't understand what it means. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, this is old news. Okay. You cannot chop the unit first, and then buy later already. Okay. So this does not work anymore. So cut. This one is rubbish advice. This is not even advice. Doesn't work anymore. Okay. We cannot chop a unit
so
first.
This is what a flat property advice is.
Dodge the ABSD by putting the home under your child's name.
I know this, you said so many times. This is a bad advice because next time your children want to buy your first house, cannot because it's going to be more expensive because it's not the first house anymore.
Yes, ABSD. So you dodge the ABSD, will your children be able to dodge? Cannot, right?
But I don't know what ABSD is.
Additional buyer stamp duty. It's a form of tax. When you buy more than one house, you have to pay more tax.
So our first house is lesser.
Correct, much lesser. The first house is 3 or 4%. The second house is 3 or 4% plus 12%. Scary, yeah.
Oh my goodness. This is why you must choose your first house very, very carefully.
Agree. So a lot of people want to dodge the ABSD by putting the home under your child's name. Okay, so I'm going to share. I read through this article. I'm going to share with you. If your child is at least 21 years old, doesn't own a property, you can buy a property under their name. Okay, let's say if Rian is 21 years old, if I'm that rich, okay, I can buy a property under her name. But we got one small problem. I'm not that rich and she's not 21. Okay, but you must understand, she's 21, I buy the house, under her name, right? She can do whatever she wants with it already.
Okay.
Yeah, you're 21, the house is yours. You can run off with your boyfriend with the money you sell for the house for.
Okay.
Will you do that to me?
No.
Yeah, you don't need to worry also because I have no money to buy you a house. Okay, never mind. So then there you see, need to consider what happens if your child sells the house, take a home equity loan on it, or that's something you don't approve of. Serious damage to our finances. But don't worry, this will never happen because daddy and mommy do have money to buy you a house. Okay. But
if you buy the house under your child's name, if you don't approve of it, then why do you buy it under their name? It's their house already, you buy it under their name. What?
Yeah, but a lot of people think they are very smart, ma. They want to own two property, but they don't want to pay the tax, ma. So they buy at whose expense? Your expense, ma. But they don't know one thing, ma. You can run off with the house, right?
Yes.
Okay, also another thing, also another thing, right? Do they have this? Okay, they don't have. Okay. Another thing about buying a property under a child. I don't know if you guys heard this thing called trust. Okay, so Rian is 12 this year, definitely not above 21. So she cannot sign any documents.
Nine years.
9 years time. So I don't need to worry that I buy a house under her name, she sell off, correct? Because she's underage, ma?
But if I'm underage, you can buy under my name.
Can. We can buy under this thing called trust. That means
trust.
The house belongs to you, but I'm holding it. I'm holding onto it for you.
So the moment I turn 21, I can do whatever.
Yes, correct. Oh. So,
okay.
Heart attack number one. Under attack. Trust, Rian reached 21, she can still do whatever she wants with the house. Okay, number one. Okay, then number two. Because Rian is under 21, I cannot get loan. She's the owner, she's the owner for the house. So she cannot get loan. So we must purchase the house
with cash.
Yes. Oh, you're so smart.
Because you say cannot get loan. So obviously.
We cannot use our CPF, we cannot use cash. And we cannot get loan. We can only use cash.
Do you even have that much cash in hand?
So you must use full cash to buy the house. And last but not least, ladies and gentlemen, some of them think that they are very smart, but please remember one thing. If today you're buying under trust, right? That property belongs to who? Rian. And if you sell the house, okay, you hold the house in for her, you sell the house for her, the money belongs to who after that?
Me.
Yes, the house money belongs to her. Even after you sell the house, the money belongs to her. Okay? If when she turns 21, you spend the money, she can challenge you in court on what happened to the money held for her under trust. Okay? Because you bought the house for her already, the money belongs to her. Isn't that wonderful?
So it's like your parents like rent it out and then the money that they earn
belongs to you.
Belongs to me.
Yes. This is buying under trust. Okay? Too bad. You don't have so rich parents. Okay. Last but not least. Buy based on low price. The lower the price, the better the investment.
You need to see the house.
Yeah.
The house.
Ah.
Later is... How do I say this?
Wow, this one very challenging. I
it may be cheap, right? It may be like very, very bad.
Yeah, I applaud Stackhomes who wrote this. For example, mega developments like Treasures at Tampines, Normanton Park, Park Clementis, Park Clematis, may be priced lower than their surrounding developments, but these mega projects have 1,000 units, over 2,000 in case of Treasures. Then what will happen in the future? There'll be multiple landlords, there'll be a lot of sellers all within the project. So you see, it all comes down to one thing. If you're selling immediately, then of course you face all these problems, right? When the house is built, everybody wants to sell, then you face this problem. But if today, you are buying for own stay, okay, for long-term stay, will you face all these problems? I don't think so, right? Okay, like the same goes for buying older properties with lower price point. Common argument that these properties outperform with the rental income. I will tell you guys this yes and no, because I myself, I bought a resale property which is at a very low price. I don't dare to say that the price will skyrocket. But come think about my current rental yield at 4.5%. 4.5% every year. Okay, I'm not confirm it's not for every year, but at least for the next 2 years. Then I bought at below 800,000. You think 10 years down the road, I'll still sell 800,000. Maybe I'll still sell 800,000, but what is the profit that I'm taking back? Correct. But rental yield makes sense. So for those of you who don't want to blindly go into investment, right? You better plan properly, go and do your proper studies. As you all know, I always talk about my ACID framework. Okay. So ACID framework, the ACE prudency test and the CED formula. No, it's not on the whiteboard. I rock clean away already. So A for affordability. C for comfortability.
And E for escapability.
Yes, when you are buying a property, please take note of these three items. If the property that you're eyeing cannot even pass these three tests, right? Then you better don't buy. Okay, just don't buy. Why risk your money? Another Bitcoin crash. Maybe you can place your money in Bitcoin. I wouldn't know. Maybe on the hustling deck, y'all can ask Jay, what are the good stocks to buy? Correct. Okay. But anyway, that's all for today. I only see two viewers remaining. Anybody has any questions? Okay, to the viewers that are watching right now, do you all have any questions? If you have, you can PM me. Okay, I'll take some questions. There. Okay, I think nobody left one only. Okay, never mind. For those of you who watch this video later part.
Maybe just leave the comments and all your questions, then maybe we can answer next video.
Maybe I'll answer in the next video, or I'll private message you. Okay, if you want, you can also private message me. You can private message me. Well, anyway, thank you all so much for whoever is still watching for your time tonight. It's going to be a long weekend. What long weekend? No, Saturday, Sunday only. Yeah, because now public holiday. School holiday. So like long weekend like that. Every day face them. Okay. Anyway, thank you all so much for joining us tonight. Okay. We'll see you in the next either The Hustling Dad or another episode of Diary of a Property Agent. So I'm Joel and this is?
Yen.
Okay. I'm Daddy Property Chef. And as I always say, a home is like a recipe. There's nothing that is perfect, but let's do our best to help you find one that suits you and your loved ones. Okay? I'm Joel. Let's make you do well.
Bye-bye. Remember to like and share and follow.
I mean, if you like what you have heard, right, please help me to like and share and follow me on Facebook. Okay? Bye-bye. Good night.